Hello and welcome to today's video blog. I'm Stephen Pilkington with the Path Home team of Compass Real Estate. So in today's video blog, we're going to talk about prospecting. And if you're in real estate, you know that one of the single most important things you can do is prospect for clients, prospect for the next opportunity for you to help somebody buy, sell, or invest in real estate. Very often, very common, realtors get into the business and then they feel like, you know, I don't want to reach out to my friends and family. I don't want to reach out to those people because I don't want them to feel obligated or awkward. And so you end up with that term, the secret agent. And I'm sure each of you who's a realtor out there knows a lot of other realtors who, some of which don't do a heck of a lot of business, even though they may have been a realtor for a long time. And oftentimes those folks are the secret agents. So number one, don't be a secret agent. Yet on the flip side of that, don't be an obnoxious agent either. Don't constantly be calling people just asking for me, me, me. What I've discovered is the more you can provide value with the people you know, the better your prospecting efforts are going to be because they're going to see that you're coming from contribution. They're going to see that you're knowledgeable about the subject and you're passionate about it. And of course, they're going to want their friends, family, coworkers, people from clubs, wherever, to work with somebody like you that's going to go ahead and lean into providing that value up front. Number two, I know a lot of people, and I did the same mistake when I got into real estate back in 2008. I was new to the area and I didn't necessarily have much of a sphere or know that many people at all. We had just relocated here. So I started spending some money on leads and thinking that, you know what, this is the fastest way for me to get some opportunities. And please do not get me wrong. You can make a great business off of internet leads or various lead types, but I want you to think about the expense that you're putting into it versus the return that you're getting out of it. So oftentimes people look at, you know, I'm going to sign up and I'm going to pay Zillow or Realtor or whoever else $1,000 a month or $2,000 a month. And in your mind, you're justifying, as long as I get one closing every 2 or 3 months out of it, it's worth it because my average closing might be $15,000. If I spend $6,000-$8,000, then it's worth it. Yet what's funny is a lot of those same individuals, and I've been there, would think to themselves, you know what, I'm not going to spend a lot of money on my past clients, sending them mailers and birthday cards and anniversary cards and inviting them to events, because that seems like it takes a lot of time and it's really expensive. Yet if you think about it, for the number of transactions that you get from an internet lead, and most internet lead services are converting right now between 1% to 3%, and that's over a 12-month period. So that means if you consistently follow up for about 12 months, then you should get about 1% to 3% of those leads converting. Of course, there are some more expensive lead services, and last I checked, Zillow in the Denver metro area could be upwards of $300 to $500 per lead. And those do convert a little bit higher, but not that much higher. So you're still gonna be buying a lot of leads to get those conversions. Where if you think about it, so let's say if you know 100 people that know you well, and let's say 30 of those are your past clients. And if let's say you decide to spend $20 a month on those 100 people, what's the math turn out to be? Well, that's about $2,000. If you have 100 people that know you, already trust you, and many of which have done business with you, and you're doing something to provide value, whether it's market updates, whether it's sending them a freebie from time to time, whether it's hosting a fun event, like we just did a trash and shredder days, and we've rented out a movie theater before, and we've done water park events, and we've sent people information so it would help them with their taxes. Those things might take a little bit more creativity and a little bit more time, yet if you invest a similar amount of money from that versus buying the internet leads, I guarantee, at least based on the results that I've seen, that you're going to do better and you're going to build a tighter community of people who are going to work with you and trust you in the future. And one of the next pieces that goes along with that, so let's say you've got your 100 people you're working with on prospecting, you're sending them mailers, you're sending them different invitations to events, but then agents will say, well, what do I talk to them about? Like, I just called them a month ago. Well, last I checked, things change in people's lives, things change in your life. The more you can take really good, consistent notes about the conversations you have with your clients, it's hard to remember everything that everyone's doing. I mean, I can't even remember all of my kids' games and practices if it wasn't on my schedule. So when I have conversations with my clients, I make sure to record that information down. So if somebody was sick, if somebody had an awesome win, if somebody graduated from high school or college or wherever, then I write that down. So when I call my client the next time, I reference that. because then it helps them realize that I care. And when they know that you care, then they're actually going to want to work with you in the future, because nobody cares how much you know until they know how much you care. One other thing I want to fill in there is that if you reach out to people at the same time, and I'm a big believer of time blocking, and oftentimes I think the morning is the best time to do your prospecting, from about 9 o'clock to about noon. Yet if you find that you're leaving messages over and over and over, switch it up. Schedule a time once a week or once a month to reach out to people from, let's say, 3:30 until 6:30, when you're getting them on drive time if they're back in work, or you're getting them at home after they get their kids, or even, dare I say it, make some phone calls on a Saturday. Call people from, and don't do it too early. We usually like to start around 9:30 or 10 o'clock, and it gives you that ability to reach people that maybe can't pick up their phone during the day for their job, or you're just not catching them at a time that you're hoping to. Text message or messaging on Instant Messenger, that also counts, but we find that you need 2 to 3 times the number of those messages versus the number of just conversations that will result in a new lead from those individuals referring you to a friend, family, coworker, neighbor, etc. So again, I hope you've gotten some value out of today's conversation about prospecting. If you have any questions and you'd like some assistance, if you'd just like to chat, please reach out. I've got the link down below. Look forward to talking with you. And until the next video blog, stay safe, stay healthy, go out there and prospect. I hope you have a fantastic day.